friends, welcome back. Today our topic is functions. So at the very beginning, I have to explain this whole part of the code to you, and then I'll come to the next part. But before that, I have to explain you what this app is on. This app's name is Planetarium, as you can see above. So what the user does is that the user inputs the weight of something in kg in this text input, and in all these labels, the weight of that particular thing, or the weight on Earth, better say, what it becomes when it goes to Mercury, when it goes to Venus, when it goes to Mars, when it goes to Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, and Pluto. All this shows up here. Okay, so the parameters, I've got it from Vital Junior, as this was one of my projects. So I think it should be clear to you by the end of this video. This block means that when text input 1 is input, so since the user is inputting something inside this text input, I'll use this input block. So from this drop down list, at the end only there's the input block which I chose. Set text label Mercury max round Mercury. So what does this mean? Set text block means that it sets the text of particular something. It set the text for the specified element, as you can see here. So this label Mercury is the ID for this particular label. So it sets the text of this one to math.round Mercury weight. What is this math round? Guys, we don't know what is this math round, so I have to explain it to you. So this math rounded block rounds off a particular number to its nearest integer. If you want, you can note it down. This math round block rounds off a number to its nearest integer, and then I call a function. So we need to call a function in order to make some app like this one. So why is calling a function required? So when we call a function, at the beginning it has no parameters, but later we have to define it. So if we don't call a function, just we define it, so how will my device understand when to use that particular function? The device does not have a brain, guys. So this block I have used over here, and the same for all these. Just what changes is that the function name and the label all the same. You can just take a screenshot, or you can just notice it, because this will take so much of my time. I'm just moving up to the next part. Before I move on, I should tell you that we are posting less videos. Hope you have noticed that, because if people are not subscribing to our channel, if you are not subscribing to our channel, what's the point in posting videos? We also need something from you now. Okay, alright. So if you feel like, you can subscribe to our channel, and we would like to request you that. Here I am defining a function. What I am defining is Mercury weight. First of all, notice one thing carefully. This spelling, only W is in capital without any caps in this Mercury weight. And over here you can see that the same spelling is over here. We have just copied and pasted it over there. If I call a particular function with a different spelling, and we define we mean to define that particular function with another spelling, then it would not work. Because I have not called that particular function, right? For the computer, as I told you, I'm again and again telling you, the computer does not have a brain. So time and again, I'm telling you that the coding should be perfect, because the computer doesn't have any sense. Okay, so this is the function. This is the block which I have taken from this function part. Not this one, okay? With parameters. I've not defined any function with parameters. I've used this block that just defines a particular function. Return. This return block is used to return some value. So if you take your cursor here, it shows it return a value from a function. So while I learned coding, I just learned all the codes by heart, what each and every block means. So it's easy for me to understand. So get number text input 1. So this get number means to get some number from a particular element. Get the number value from a specified element. So return this block. Then I have used a multiplication block. Inside the multiplication block, as you can see over here, in this part I have input this get number block, and in the other part I have input 0.3, which is the parameter. So I have defined all the functions similarly. So what if we don't use a particular block? What if we don't use a return block? We just write this much, get number this thing into this. So that won't work because I have to return a value in a particular place. So for my computer to return that value, we need to use this return block. If my computer only does maths and does not return it back to a person who is trying to understand a sum by using the calculator, then what's the point for the computer in calculating? No point. So that's why we are using this return block. And I've done the same for all these, I think 9 or 8, yeah. For all these 8 functions. So this is how we define a function, and this is how we call a function. So on and on, I'm telling you that this is the call a function block. This is the call a function block that is on my screen, and this is the define a function block. And don't use this block currently because I have not posted any videos regarding this. If you want, you can use it to learn coding from some other place. You can certainly do that. But I would not prefer you to use this parameter because the parameter is perfect for you to use this thing. So if your parameters are not perfect, coding can go. So as I told you, coding is done. But if you want some extra tricks on the defining part, I can certainly explain that. So better you watch the video till the end. Here are all the labels. This is one text input, and these are all the labels. So how have I made these labels like this with a white background? That's simple, very, very simple. From here I have chosen the background color as white. So I will tell you one thing, transparency. This transparency, this does not have any, this has so much of this, I mean, this has color. And it's not transparent. It does not have any transparency. If I want more of its transparency to vanish it, see, I've just removed its transparency and this is how it will look like. But I don't want all of them to be similar. That's why I have not used any transparency. Similarly, I've done for all these. That is a text input, this is a label, all these are labels, all these are labels, only this one is the text input. Now for the background, I've chosen a background color from here. How have I done that? I've uploaded a file from my device and it came like this, and I clicked on choose and it just became the background. So I'd like to once preview this app, but before that I would also like to request you that if you already haven't subscribed to Coding Station yet, subscribe now and don't forget to like, share, comment. Alright, so I run it. Wait on the Earth. For example, it's 12. Weight on Mercury is 4, weight on Venus is 11, weight on Mars is also 4, weight on Jupiter is 29, weight on Saturn is 11, weight on Uranus is 10, weight on Neptune is 13, and weight on Pluto is 1. See, the coding is done perfectly. If you notice carefully, 12 into 0.06 becomes 1. So these are the parameters which were given to me in the Vita Junior project, and I have followed exactly these parameters. If you know, see, I've done it similarly, and if I write 1 on Earth, this is what comes out. So I hope you guys like this video. Don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe certainly. This is Coding Station signing out. Thank you.